Outlaws had received a beating, which did nothing to help their opinion of Bright Lodge. Sending legends to fight vagabonds? That hardly seemed fair.
Ooh. Well, look who it is. Little idiot has sent his little friends. Well, you're too late. I found friends of my own. Friends who appreciate me. And booze. They appreciate booze. So if you don't mind, you can go shove Wendy glass right off the waterfall.
Pagog! 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 Pagog!
Beckett had been rather less happy to see the heroes than they'd been expecting. But Bright Lodge depended on getting him back. They had to push on.
Ha! my dander? Just rub it a little and you'll be fine.
Beckett had clearly enjoyed his holiday in the mountains, but it was coming to an end. He was coming back to Bright Lodge, like it or not.
I make other noises too, if anyone's interested.
This Beckett is drying my infinite well of patience.
Beckett was nowhere to be seen, for those unsteady legs were surprisingly nimble. The heroes had no choice but to push deeper into the camp.
Ha! there.
That didn't mean it would be easy to carry him back to town. He didn't look like he'd washed for a while, and he seemed like he'd be a wriggler.
There. He had his chance. He didn't listen, and now we're all going to die. Well, might as well have some fun in the meantime.
The Culliscate had bought Beckett a little time, but the heroes would surely catch him, and all that old kingdom magic was only going to make his hangover worse.
Pretty impressive place, but I think I prefer a castle with a roof.
Don't let it get moving! see my toes and think, you look like happy little sausages.
You're the Belverine's bollocks.
Oh no, there's a hero that ticks all my boxes.